We are on MCA TV at the Birth Congress 2018 in Venice. We are with Professor Eduardo Fonseca, Professor of Obstetric and Gynecologist, Federal University of Paraíba in Brazil, and President of Perinatal Branch of OBG Brazilians Association. Welcome. Can you tell us something about the strategies of prevention of preterm births?
Yes, well, the preterm birth is maybe one of the worst problems in perinatology in nowadays. And the first step of these strategies is to understand that preterm birth, it's not a disease, but preterm birth, it's a syndrome with different risk factors. And the second important thing is to divide preterm birth into groups, the iatrogenic or medical indicated preterm birth and spontaneous preterm birth. We are going to discuss today the strategies to decrease the rate of spontaneous preterm birth. And the most important risk factor associated with spontaneous preterm birth in the indexed pregnancy is the cervical length. We know that the shorter the cervix, the higher the risk of preterm birth. So, in this sense, it's important to have the cervical assessment for every single patient to identify those with short cervix less than 25 millimeters, and in such group we are going to have a specific treatment in order to reduce the rate of preterm birth.
So one of the treatments in this case is progesterone. What can you tell us about progesterone role and if progesterone is underused in clinical practice, in your opinion?
Yes. The history of progesterone and the prevention of preterm birth goes back to 1970. The first paper was published by Emily Papernick, and he demonstrated clearly that progesterone reduced the rate of preterm birth. But unfortunately, they forget progesterone, and only in 2003, after a study published in the American Journal of Obstetrics and Gynecology, the progesterone was reborn, and nowadays we know that the vaginal progesterone reduced the risk of preterm birth in patients with prior history of preterm birth, and in patient with short cervix, singleton patient with short cervix less than 25 millimeters, and twins pregnancies with short cervix less than 25 millimeters too. And the mechanism is unclear, but we know that progesterone first has anti-inflammatory properties in the cervix, and progesterone has a relaxation effect on the myometrium cells. So there is increase in the quiescence of uterus, and there is anti-inflammatory properties in the cervix of the womb, in the cervix of the uterus.
So what can we do to educate healthcare provider to a correct use of progesterone?
I think the most important thing is to bring these informations for every single patient. Secondly, we need to spread these informations through the meetings like this one, the birth. For example, next Saturday is the World Day for Prematurity, and we are going to discuss a lot these strategies to reduce the rate of preterm birth, both spontaneous preterm birth and medical indicated preterm birth. But I think the most important thing is for the big societies in the world, in each country, push the government to start screening patients. So when you talk about screening, and now you talk about the importance of cervical assessment, the importance to measure the cervix in the mid-trimester, sometimes the government doesn't want to put money in. Screening means money. And sometimes they are not able to understand that it's much better to put money for screening and identify patients to reduce the disease the complications rather than to put money to treat the disease. So it's very expensive to treat patients in the neonatal intensive unit care. So I think the society, the Brazilian society, the American society, the Italian society, needs to push the government to understand the best strategy to avoid disease is to predict the risk, the personal risk, and to give the right treatment to avoid that disease. In this case, preterm birth.